I've opened up the document we've been working with, ODP07, a simple doc.odp that I downloaded from my website, thefrugalcomputerguy.com, and I am in the normal view. I also want to mention that I went back to version 5.0.3.2, so I do have my tabs back in my workspace window. I'm going to click on the Handouts tab, and we see the slide content disappeared, as well as the slide pane on the left. We see a blank page with placeholders on it. This dark text up at the top, headers, date and time, footer, and number, we're going to talk about that in the next video. Right now, we're just going to look at these placeholders. Over in our sidebar, we see the message, properties for the task we are performing are not available. To get rid of this message, just select one of the placeholders. The Handouts tab is made for handouts, meaning printed copies of the presentation for the attendees to follow along with and take notes on. Looking at our choices over here, we can put one slide per page, two slides per page. Now on this three slides per page, in the layout property, it looks like we have some lines on the right or our notes. This is a little misleading because there are no lines or notes to the right of our slides when we print this out. Then we also have 4, 6, and 9 slides per page. I think the 9 slides per page may make the printout a little hard to read, but depending on the content and what your handouts are for, you may want to use 9 slides per page. I think I like the 4 slides per page. And in the workspace here, it looks like we are in portrait view, whereas our layouts property shows us in landscape. To change our workspace to show things in landscape, I'm going up into Format Page in our standard toolbar, and I'm going to change the orientation to landscape. And now I'm going to click on the Print button. We could also go into File, Print, or press Control P. This brings up our Print dialog box. We see we've got our slides here on the left that we can click through. But the slides don't fill up the page that well, because we set the slides to print as 16 by 9 for our projector screen. To fix that, I'm going back into the normal view, and again, coming up to the Format Page Slide button, and changing the screen size to 4x3. Now going back to the Print dialog box, we see that our slide fills the entire page. We can select the printer that we want to print on, and then below that we have range and copies. I want to print all the slides, and the number of copies is set to 1. If I change this to 2 or more, we see the collate is checked by default. That will print every slide 1, 2, 3, and then start with slide 1 again, then 2, 3, until it gets through all the copies. If I uncheck collate, we see it will print all the page 1s, then all the page 2s, then all the page 3s. There may be times that you want to do that, but most often, I think you're going to want to use the collate. I'm going to set this back to a single copy again. Coming back over to the range, we can choose what slides to print. Right now it's set at 1, just the first page. If we want to print pages 1 through 3, we'll print slides 1, 2, 3, and then a comma, I'll add in 5. So I want it to print pages 1 through 3 and page 5. Selection would be if I made a selection before I brought up the print dialog box. It would print out that selection. I don't have any selected, so there's nothing here. And then print in reverse order. That's a checkbox. Checking this will print the slides in the reverse order. That's if you have a printer that prints the first page, page up, then prints the second page, page up, which goes on top of the first, and the third page goes on top of that, making the first page the last page in your document. Printing in reverse order would fix that problem. Most printers sold today don't print that way. I'm going to uncheck that, and I want to change this back to all slides, because down here where we see print, this is what we're really looking for. We're going to print the document as slides. That's why we saw all five. Remember, we changed things in the handout view. So clicking this drop down shows us we can print that slides, handouts, notes, or outline. I want to print the handouts. Now we see the four slides per page, and going to the second page shows us that fifth slide. Below this document, we have slides per page according to the layout. I can change that and make this one slide per page, or going down to four. We can also change the left, right, then down. So we see that here's our first slide. Here's our second with the three bullets. See, we've got our three bullets on slide two. But if I change the order to top to bottom, then right, we notice that our second slide now is below the first. So we have slide one, slide two, slide three, and slide four. I'm going to change this back to according to layout. And let's go over to the next tab, LibreOffice Impress. Under the contents, we haven't talked about slide name, date, and time yet. We'll get to those later. In hidden pages, we looked at a few videos back. If we hide a page, clicking that will print all the slides, including the hidden slides. The color option, we've got original colors, grayscale. We can see everything's gray. If we go to black and white, we notice that our first slide does not have any gray in it at all. So there is a slight difference between grayscale and black and white. And then down under sizes, we've got original size. There's also fit to printable page. Depending on your printer, this may increase your slides a little bit to fit the page better. But if your printer can't handle it, it does not do anything. Under layout, pages per sheet, we've got this set to one. I only have two pages, so I can set this to two. If I set this to more than that, let's say we go to nine pages per slide, it makes it very small, but we can see four would be our first slide, this would be our second, and we can see if we draw a border around each page, we see here slide one, slide two. I'm going to undo the border, change this back to one. And then this last tab of options, the only one I'm going to look at is print to file. And I'm going to print this out to a file right now. I'll put this on my desktop and I will call this ODP07. And it will print as a PDF or a portable document format. And looking on the desktop, here it is. Double clicking to open it. Shows my document as a PDF. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.